Hello, YouTube. Hello, everybody. So, it's me back doing a little solo stuff. So, first of all, the reason me and Steven haven't been doing videos is because I've been playing around with the bucket servers. Finally got myself one. It's really awesome. Not finished yet. Definitely not finished yet. It's not going to be public, so don't be asking. And I was going to do this little series on all of my bucket plugins that I have now and how they all work. So this is going to be a part series. It's not going to be all in one video. And I like to get started. I'm actually doing this at 2:30 in the morning. I don't know. Just not tired. But let's go ahead and start up our server. So as you can see, our server is going to generate a lot of plugins. Give it a second. Okay, so it's got all its plugins. Now, plugins that I have right now are, let's just start from the top. Chat Manager is part of Permissions X. Modify World is also part of Permissions X. VoxelPort. So let's go over VoxelPort first. Okay, so VoxelPort is, as you know, part of the Voxel, people. I'm sorry. I'm tired. But yeah, this is our server so far. This is the port, and those are all the rules and stuff. So, basically, what this allows you to do is set up teleporters. Each one of these is actually a teleporter, and we set them up to require tickets. And using another fancy-dancy plugin, which is Chess Shop, we have ticket booths over here where you can buy tickets from these signs. I will actually do so. With money, which is another plugin I have, and I will show you that later. So when you're on this, I'm going to show it now. The one plugin I have is Iconomy, which everybody has. And since I'm the admin, I have so much money. But if you right-click on a sign, you get whatever is in the chest that it's selling. And if you left-click on a sign, you can sell whatever it's selling. But as you can see, we don't have it set up to sell. So once you have your ticket, actually, there will be somebody here. Let's change my bet to creative. There will be somebody in the booths most at all times getting paid as their job and to flip that switch, and that's these gate controls, just so nobody goes in. They need a ticket. A ticket, but you know. So let's start off in the market because nothing else is finished. So basically what we have here is we have a teleporter set in between these two blocks. And we have the teleporter set to when you enter the blocks with the specified ticket, it will take your ticket away and you will get teleported to wherever you have the receiving end on. So I'm going to quickly show you how to set up one of these teleporters. So we're just going to use gold blocks and iron blocks. Also for this, I'm not going to go over any of the configs or anything, but it's all in text edit and stupid stuff. What this is it shows all your ports, and these are the ports we have as of now. You need an admin's text in, and yes, it is spelled like that or it won't work, in your plugins folder. And basically, if you want people to be able to create teleporters with VoxelPort, you put their name in that admin's text. So, let's go ahead and get back to our Minecraft. So, basically, what we're going to do is we're just going to start up a small little teleporter, and we're gonna have us just for show right now just teleport right to these gold to silver. So what you do is you look at a block and you type VP space point, and it'll say first point set. Then look up to your second block and type VP point again, and then it'll set your second block. Now just type VP create, and then we'll just a name, and we'll call it test, and it creates the portal. Now let's create this portal. So VP point, and if you don't have your name in the admin's text, when somebody tries to do this, it'll say this weird error message that I don't remember off the top of my head, but it'll say an error message, so don't worry about that. And then we're just going to create test, and it all has to be in one word, by the way, or it will not work. So what we're going to do is now we're going to link these. So we're going to tell that this, as you can see, there's a portal there, but it has nowhere to go. And you can also set departure times and dispatch times and all this complicated stuff. But basically what we're going to do is we're going to type VP target, which, and then test, which will tell this teleporter that this is its target block. Now, as of now, it doesn't have a pass set for it. Now, to turn on passes, you type VP require ticket true. You always need the true. I typed that wrong, didn't I? Oh, wow, I feel really stupid. I forgot the E. Require ticket true. And then, as you can say, it'll say that. As our server has, in your config files, in the voxel port settings, sorry, I'm a little laggy because of all the videoing going on. But in here, the port ticket is 39, it's originally leather. We have it set as paper because, you know, paper isn't like a passport. But you can change that to whatever you like. So if we take, if we just stand in there now, nothing will show up. I'm not sure why I did that. Let's just try typing it again. Oh, we didn't type in the teleporter. Require tickets, test true. And then now this has a ticket requirement. Now it won't say anything when you enter the teleporter until you take out your piece of paper or whatever it is and you hold it in your hand. If it's not in your hand, if it's just in your hotbar, it won't work. Now, if you don't want a ticket, you just type VP insta port test or whatever your portal's name is true. And now that this is set to Instaport, as soon as you step into it, and it doesn't work, let's try targeting it again. By the way, the block you're standing on is the target location, not the thing you're looking at. We got to turn required ticket off. So you have to turn your required tickets command to false if you want it off. So once it's at false, then you can teleport to your receiving block. Now let's go over here, and if you're in your chat bar, it will not teleport you. So we'll do VP target test end, and then it has targeted that. Now we'll do VP Instaport test and true, and then that is true, and there's no required ticket, I think. There might be required ticket test and false. Okay, and then we'll just change the time real quick. Now when you stand in, there's where it can get you. Instaport test and true. I don't think I typed that in. And I spelled it wrong. Of course, I'm typing too fast. Okay, so Instaport test and true. Okay, of course I would spell it wrong. And now there. Okay, so that's the basic setup for the teleporters, for voxel port. To delete a teleporter, they probably are still there, actually, so, yeah, they're still there. So, to delete a teleporter, just type VP deletes, and then the name. So we'll delete test, VP deletes, test, end. And then your teleporters are deleted. Now, we're in the market. This will be a fairly long video. So we're in the market. We might as well go over the chess shops. So chess shops basically allow you to create shops with chests. As you can see here, I have a little instruction. And we have all our little booths or little shops that have chests in them that are filled with the items. Now, if I was an admin, and actually I will change that using, look at me using stuff that you don't know what is. Permissions X, I'm going to set myself as a guest, which is one of the groups I have. And then I'll de-op myself. Okay, now that I'm not an admin and de-op, when I try to access the chest, I don't have permission to do that. So, that's how you use chest security, and I need to open up this so I can get back into my admin stage. Set admin. Okay, and then up. Yeah, okay. Up, like, 1, 2, 3. Okay, now that I'm admin and stuff, I can grade it. But as you see, the top line says Carthonage, which is one of my friends that owns the market. If you notice, as I entered the market area, there's little text at the bottom of the screen. Those are part of regions. World Guard, which I'll explain later. As you can see, it says, "Hello, welcome to the market, owned by Carthonage." So he owns all the shops, so his name is going to show up on top of the shops. Now, I'm going to show you how to set up a shop. So you take your chest and take your item that you're selling. Let's do torches. And then a sign. So all you have to do is take your chest. I also have Lock It On, which locks your chests. If you place a sign on them, it'll put a sign that says private and nobody else can open it. That is weird. LCW. Okay. LCW is another chest lock. Wow, I am lagging. My own computer is just lagging. But that is, wow. This is terribly annoying. But LCW, as you saw, was a different chest lock thingamabob. And now if we type /reload, which is part of just the bucket, the craft bucket, it'll restart our server, and we won't have chest lock and all that. Stop, leave this place, you annoy me. Oh, there it is. I didn't even see it. Okay, so I was actually looking at LCW not too long ago to see if I like it better than Lock It, and I actually don't because it is annoying. But now that that's gone, we can get back into Minecraft. Wow, Minecraft is not laggy, but everything else is. So let's reload the server. And reloading will not affect all your players. Okay, so now that, I'm sorry about this, guys. But anyways, to set up a shop, you have a sign near a, chest. Now, skip the first line, because that's where your name will show up. Or, in the config files, what the name of the store will be. Now, on the second one is the amount of items you're selling. So, if you type 1, you'll sell 1 torch, in our case. On the next line, you can type, this is where, this is where the price is for buying and the price is for selling. So if you type capital B or lowercase b, it doesn't matter, then the price of the item, which we'll just do 5. Then if you do the 2 dots, post in the comments if you know what that's called, I forget, and then S, and then the amount that you want to sell it, if you want to sell it. You know, you can leave that blank and it's not sellable. But let's say we want to sell torches for $2. Then on the next line, you will type what you're selling. So torch. And then you click done, and it'll create the shop successfully. Now, you just place your torch in there, and then, you can't buy from your own shops, which is terribly annoying, but, this uses, see, if you right-click on your sign, it'll open the chest for you, but other players can come in and right-click and buy. To delete your shop, just break the sign, and you're done. But anyways, the whole shop concept uses iconomy, which is the concept behind money. So if we do iconomy, I think it just shows us our balance. Okay, so if we do iconomy help, there we go. So these are all the commands for iconomy. You can give players, you can pay them, so you can have jobs and purge accounts, empty the accounts, all this cool stuff. Cool stuff, and Chess Shop uses that. So I think I'm going to wrap up this video for you guys on my first episode of my Bucket plugins, and I hope to see you guys next time, and I hope so far with Voxel Sniper and Chess Shop and all the other confusing things you saw that you don't know what do yet helped so far. That was a mouthful. But, no homo. But, I'm just kidding. So, I hope to see you guys next time. Bye, everybody.